Doing regular computing becomes automatic for me now, making a simple question like 2 plus 3 very scary, because I don't even know how to think about it. But if I can't explain, how am I going to understand how computers know? Before answering those, there is a bigger question. What are you doing when you are computing? As said before, to make sense of large quantities and record them properly, we need to organize them into different buckets by bundling up every 10 objects and place it into the next bin. We then create the basic symbols to record the number of bundles inside each bucket. That's the name of this quantity, which we can use to communicate with others. To help ourselves get familiar with those quantities, we create vocal names for them. By also naming those different bundles, we have a systematic way of speaking out any quantities by specifying the number of different bundles and residues. Vocal names are crucial in counting. For example, facing flocks of sheep, there is no way we can organize and bundle these sheep easily. But by imposing vocal names one by one against the sheep, we are effectively organizing them in our head, making it easy to record the symbol names accordingly. Why would we need to compute in the first place? Say I'm a farmer and now I want to expand my farm by acquiring neighbor's sheep. When the underlying physical quantity changes to a new one, we need to find out the new name to keep track of things. With the extra sheep, how many you have now? How to find out? Well, if I had little education, I would count. Why? Because counting is the most obvious way to find out how many objects I have. Count one by one until the final sheep. Then I record the name of this new quantity. But what if I have more and more sheep? It's a lot of work to do physical counting. And also, when I took possession of the sheep, I would have already done counting. Why redo the work? Facing tedious and repetitive work, time to think of a better way. This physical process of merging two quantities into a new one means that symbols representing them will interact with each other, producing a new symbol. The implication is there are relationships among these basic symbols. Let's see how we can find them. To understand the relationships among those symbols, we need to know the meanings of those abstract symbols. Each place represents a different bundle size. To add a new number, we are actually merging two physical quantities. Same size buckets can be combined because they are for the same types of bundles. Whenever reaching 10 objects, time to bundle up and put aside. Proceed until all the bundles are merged properly. In the end, record the number of bundles in each bin. That's the name for the new quantity. This is saying that the symbol of 2 and 9 will merge into 11. Because this one represents a bigger bundle in the next bucket, it should be placed aside to be combined with other bundles. What this is saying is there are some basic pairwise relationships among those symbols. For positional number system, no matter what the quantity is, there are only a few possibilities in each place. For example, in our Arabic case, only 10 possibilities. Since each place can be combined separately, all we need to do is to figure out the outcomes from this pairwise combination. These 10x10 pairwise relationships are captured by the addition table, telling us what a new symbol is when two numbers interact. Picking 2 plus 3 as an example, imagine two buckets with 2 and 3 objects in them. Then merge the two buckets. Identify the corresponding quantity in the list, finding out the symbol name. That's why 2 plus 3 is 5. An easier way to do so is to start with a symbol for 2, switching 3 times. Each switching represents the physical action of merging the bars, arriving at the same symbol. Let's pick 4 plus 8 as another example. We can get rid of these imaginary buckets now. You start with 4, switching 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, exceeding the list, meaning that we have reached 10 objects, Time to bundle up and move aside. And 7, 8 times. That's why the name would have two positions, with the one and the ending symbol in there. That's the answer. The whole addition table can be crunched this way. Once the basic symbols are decided, it's fully determined by the basic symbols. What I mean by determined is, once these basic symbols are chosen, the computing rules will have to follow. For example, because we can choose any symbols to represent these basic quantities, I can certainly switch this to. But then, this addition table will also change. So, these symbols add up to what really depend on what they represent. For multi-digit addition, we simply look up from the table for pairwise combinations. The trick is, when we're adding two middle ones, be aware of carry in and carry out. So we place the carry out on top as temporary value to be combined with the next digit. Just an extra step of pairwise combination. The multiplication table comes from successive addition. So it's also determined by the basic symbols. So computing is really just a tool human invented to quickly find out the name for the new quantity when the underlying physical quantity changes, instead of sweating over physical counting again and again. But how can computers know 2 plus 3 equals to 5? To understand this, you need to see computing as purely mechanics, requiring little consciousness. It's best illustrated through computing using non-familiar number base and symbols. After we choose the basic symbols to represent increasing quantities for computing, all we need is to create the computing table, such as this addition table. To fill it up, you will have to understand what each symbol represents. For example, to add a star and a cloud, you begin with a star. Knowing that cloud means 3, you switch 3 times. Exceeding the symbol list means that we need 2 positions, with the 1 and the ending symbol in there. The whole table can be obtained by switching. Then you can throw this table to almost anyone to do computing. They don't need to understand the meanings of those symbols. They just need to look up from the table for pairwise combinations. Whenever there is a carry out, place it on top of the next position to be combined consecutively. Well, how do we know it's correct? Then we need to translate these symbols to our familiar Arabic numbers. Now we need to know the meanings of those symbols. 4 basic symbols mean that we'll have unique symbols for quantities up to 3. Reaching 4, time to bundle up and move aside so that we can reuse the same basic symbols. So each higher position represents 4 times the previous one. Combining the meaning of each symbol with its positional value, it is saying that 6 plus 14 equals to 20. So you think that you know how to compute because you understand. But from this example, we see that we're perfectly able to compute by simply following the table, without any understandings. So the nature of computing is really a boring task of crunching symbols by following rules, requiring little brain work. The key in designing a computing machine is around designing the computing table so that whoever doing the computing will follow. We're going to see that from the next video about how to design computers. We will start with who is computing on what and where.